I was 14 years old, and I was at Muslim youth camp. Two of my friends and I had a busy day. They always packed them for us. We decided we just needed to go out, go for a walk. We snuck out. We knew we were supposed to. We went down by the beach, and we sat by the lake. Ended there. Of course, we had cops. The night patrol, the uncles who walked around and made sure we were all safe and sleeping, found out that we were there. We got in trouble. They were angry. We broke the rules. We shouldn't be out at night. They were right. But life is so confusing, and everyone seemed to have expectations of us. And we just needed to hear the quiet of the water and see the sparkle of the stars and remind ourselves who we are as women, as Muslims, as people. I just needed to feel the still inside of me. Well, my beloved teacher, Mary Ellie, took me aside that week and said she knew our hearts were fluttering. And she knew we were anxious to spread our wings, but she guided us to learn before we flew. Because if we were to learn first, then when we did fly, we would go far. Empowering youth. My advice for empowerment is that in this fast-changing world, stay constant to three things: fire, family, faith. Haish, Khandan, Khuda. Fire. Whether you're at school and love to draw, but you're worried about taking a drawing class, means you have to take another class outside of your major. Or you want to start your own business, but you know the chances of failure are great. Feed the fire in your belly. Do it. Failure is inevitable. But when you feed your fire, success is probable. Family. Nurture the relationships and support that our family and our community and friends can give us. We all have Instagram accounts. I have lots of friends on Facebook. And I'm gaining some LinkedIn connections. But support, the kind we really need, comes from those who see us, who know us, who criticize us, and always love us. Deep down, that's our family. And faith, knowing that you and I take every step of our lives with our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at our side. This feeling of taqwa makes the difficulties and the challenges doable. And it makes the triumphs, such as tonight, even more meaningful. Because I know my Creator, the being that made me, knew today was coming. Even when I was at my lowest, He helped me get here. I wonder where He knows you and I will be tomorrow. Nothing I could have predicted that a strong-willed, mischievous girl, who always got in trouble, and several of the uncles here know that, who worried her parents and her teachers and who broke the rules, would be here today. Nothing, really. Not my grades, not my failures, not my jobs. But if I look back, MCC, whether it was the youth camps, the Sunday school where I attended way too many years of my life, was constant in my life. MCC is where I developed the fire for community service and for teaching. So I now serve the most vulnerable students in our community in the public school education system. It was where I belonged with my immigrant parents and my family, and where I found my new family because my husband Yusuf was also an MCC kid. And MCC is where I learned to love my Creator and our faith. Feed your fire, stay true to your family and your community, picture your faith.